But there were others a good deal more aggressive even than Aziza's father. Shazna, a Sri Lankan preschool owner who converted to Islam at the age of 17, tried unsuccessfully to hide the bitterness in her with a laugh.
When I embraced Islam and I start to recite the Quran in my room, at my home, so my dad said it and he got angry. Once he kicked me and started to scold me. And once he said, if you are a Muslim, this is a Roman Catholic family, if you want to be a Muslim continuously, you go out. At that time, I think the time is midnight, 3 o'clock. My father kicked me out. I miss my friends. I had a lot of friends in my school time. So I miss my friends. When I embraced Islam, they didn't talk with me. So I love to talk with them.
But not all non-Muslim parents were hostile. Priscilla, an Indonesian convert who converted from Christianity to Islam after hearing the call to prayer in Indonesia and searching for its meanings on the internet. She told us about her family's reaction.
I was glad because my father said, okay, whatever you choose, I'm glad for you. If you feel better with it, then you have to do that, but do it the right way. So I was so glad because I knew another sister. She had problems with her parents, but my parents were very supportive.
Priscilla's case was too good to be true, so I asked Amber the same question. Amber is a school teacher from Connecticut in the United States who became Muslim after 9/11 while working in New York.
My family accepted me after I converted to Islam. They saw that it made me happy. They saw that it was something that was improving me, not the opposite. They did have some reservations, of course, as anyone would, because they were afraid. They knew a lot of stereotypes from the media about Islam, and they thought this might be something that would happen to me, that I would, you know, not socialize with people that I used to know, that I might dress differently, totally different than them. That things would be totally different. When they realized it wasn't, then they were able to accept me. After I wore hijab, it was again difficult for them because it set me apart. But then it was a process. It took time for them to again realize that it wasn't something that would set me apart. It was just something that was part of my religious and spiritual journey.